Singapore was young, dancing was also very young. The Indians here, they didn't understand what is Bharatanatyam was all about. They know dance. So Mr. Bhaskar came and taught dance from the 52 to 55. I arrived in 55. So 52-53 years, he taught some dance dramas. So it is simple techniques which anybody can adapt and learn. And he taught quite a number of young female dancers. There was not many male dancers at that time who learned dance from him, although he was a male dancer. So we didn't have many, you know, as usual, even now too. So he composed, choreographed dance dramas where everybody will have a role. So stories from Mahabharata, and that was quite popular because people like to see act and dance together with music. And when you talk about dance, you must understand Indian dance is connected with music. Without musicians, you cannot dance. And that early period, there was no pre-recorded music available. It was all, you know, the long playing records, which used to get it from India. And they were not very good standard recording. So Mr. Bhaskar was, there was 2-3 musicians here who could play harmonium and he could sing. And there was a mridangam person, Mr. Guruswami and Ramlinga Vadyar and violin. They were all not very professionally trained for playing for dance, but they were okay for Carnatic music. And they used to work in Radio Singapore too. So they were the musicians who helped Mr. Bhaskar to compose music and then do these dance dramas. So audience was also very young and enthusiastic to see any new thing. You know, there was not much of entertainment at that time. There's no TV, only radio and Tamil movies. So this dance scene became very, very vibrant at that time. So everybody started, appreciating Indian dance. It is something different, colorful, you know. So that is how the scene at that time was.